name is Matthew Woolwork. Ever since the beginning of school, I have been playing video games and enjoying them. However, ever since around about grade 5, I've become very interested in developing my own video games. Of course, though, I didn't have the resources or knowledge to do so, and this frustrated me quite a lot. And today, I'm going to be showing you the product I've been able to create, finally after all these years. I'm going to be showing you the process of making this game and the goals I had while making it. Late grade 10, I learned how to use the video game development tool called Unity 3D. I've been able to code video games for the first time. For my IT assignment, which is about game development, I decided not only to just make a game and get good marks, I want to impress my colleagues and engage sort of a community about my game. Before I even started thinking about the gameplay though, I already had an image in my head about what I wanted it to look like. I wanted it to look like sort of a combination of Tron, the movie Tron, and the video game Tempest in 1981. This would not only make it easier to build the game, because I can't make realistic graphics, but it would make the game have its own unique feel. So now I had a workaround for my terrible 3D modeling skills. I could now come up with some game concepts. My first idea was a first-person shooter with an open-world environment. But I completely ditched the idea because, well, it's been done to death. And plus, it didn't fit the open world design I had for the game originally. Instead, I decided to go for a physics puzzle sort of game, which had set it out from the rest. So, the players would have a physics gun to be able to shoot things, and which would make objects move around. And so, I decided to have an open world map where people would be able to come to dungeons and stuff. And to get to the new dungeons, they'd have to upgrade their physics gun from the other levels. However, it looked good on paper, but in reality, I had such a large world, I couldn't fit objects in it to make the world populated. It was basically a complete barren wasteland. Players didn't really like the game, since they had no idea what to do, and it was barely playable, and I only had one level. I had to make changes fast to get people interested in the game and to up my mark for my assignment. So I decided to change the game format to be linear, which for non-gamers means there's a set path to follow. So I did that. This helped me also fill my world with objects to make it not be completely barren, so players could do things. People started to become interested, which is good. But one problem: they had no way to actually get the game. I had to give it to them individually. So, next slide, please. So, this did help build the fact that this did help the game become people become interested, since not many people get it, but of course, that means the appeal would have spread that wide because hardly anyone had it. So, I set up a website for people to be able to play the game in their browser. However, later on, I changed into a download because the browser version of the game had all bugs that you could count. news around the game and stuff had spread around the whole of senior IT. I had people who weren't even interested in playing games playing it, or in my year level, in fact. Lots of people playing, I was also getting a lot of feedback. This helped me greatly since I knew exactly what people wanted to know and fixed a lot of bugs I had. A lot of bugs. Although, unfortunately, lots of bugs also came with lots of great expectations. There were a lot of features I knew I shouldn't add in, but people really wanted. You know, people wanted a mobile part of the game, which just wouldn't work. And people wanted multiplayer. I tried implementing, but it just didn't fit with the gameplay style. However, I did make the game a little easier since I made the levels incredibly difficult. My style of game making, and even then they still complained. Right, so today, this game has had, I think, over 100 downloads, which is pretty cool. I think that well.